Sorry?
You aren't meant to be filming in here either.
Who said?
It's Meadowhall policy.
Yeah, I've got no problem with you for recording it at all.
We don't have to prove to you, we're exempt.
Right, but we're going to be asking you to leave the centre for the day.
No, you're not. I'd like to see one car, please.
Guys, it's private property.
I'd like to see one
car.
You've
now been asked to leave.
I'm leaving personally. Please, you want a car.
Police are claiming, under the Public Order Act 1986, Section 16, this is not described as a public space. But I think they're getting mixed up with policy and law here.
I'm assuming as a police officer, show
me a warrant
card. You're being asked to leave the centre. You're now trespassing. You're not trespassing. I've asked you to show me a warrant card because I believe you're personally a police officer if you haven't got your warrant card on you.
You're going to be arrested for
breach of peace. We're not breaching the peace. We're not breaching the peace at all.
So there's broken skin there. And what did they give as an excuse to arrest you?
They said, oh, I've been injured as well.
Oh, your arms are injured, yeah?
Yeah.
Oh my God.
So let me just double check that. Anywhere else?
Have you got your warrant card? Because if you've got your warrant card, right, mate. Don't touch me. Get off me.
Get your hands off me. Get your fucking hands off me. Get your hands off me.
So I really don't know where to point my camera here. However, sorry?
You aren't meant to be filming in here either.
Who said?
It's Meadowhall policy.
Right.
Yeah, it's here off the back rock.
There you go. There you go. The government website says you don't have to create a doctor. You don't have to provide exemption. Well, we can go wherever we want with that mask on. Well, we're exempt, so that's what we have to say to you. Anymore, you have to be breaking the law.
By
the
hassle.
But I'm not having a problem with you.
Trying to help the constables.
Just trying to help you so you don't have to wear a mask. Have you not seen the videos on YouTube or put inside the mask now?
Right, well, you need to do a bit of research. Every time I see a constable, I approach him with exactly the same conversation.
Why do you think Dr. Fauci's on the run hiding in America
and
they're trying to arrest him? He wrote a best-selling book, Dr. Fauci, the one who says everyone has to wear a mask. But in his book, he says the Spanish flu, if you want to look at it, we're meant to exempt, we don't have to prove to you we're exempt.
Right, but we're going to be asking you to leave the centre for the day.
No, you're not. Right, if you want a personal liability claim against you personally, we'll sue you for breach of the Disability Discrimination Act. We don't have to go anywhere.
It's not a public place.
Yes, it is.
Oh, yes, it is. Oh, no, no.
Oh, right.
Yeah,
don't tell us about the law, mate. I know the law.
Seriously, I'm just
going to
show you something.
So the police are claiming under the Public Order Act 1986, Section 16, this is not described as a public space. But I think they're getting mixed up with policy and law here. Criminal Justice Act, 1972, Section 33 also defines this as a public space.
No, it's not.
However, policy is what they're trying to enforce here. So it's not the law about filming on public spaces. This could turn into trespass soon when people are asked to leave.
I'd like to see one car, please. By law, you've got to prove your warrant card. I'm not being aggressive to you at all. No, you're harassing us. You're harassing us when we're not breaking the law.
Your presence isn't welcome here anymore.
I've asked you to show me warrant card.
You need to leave or you're going to be arrested.
We're not breaking any law.
Why are you asking to leave? Because we're not wearing masks. That's disability discrimination.
Because you failed to comply with a reasonable request.
No, right.
And you're also getting
You're committing disability. I'm caught to the law. If you refuse to leave, you become a trespasser. What law are you?
Common law, sir.
Yeah, we know all about common law, mate.
Yeah, well, now with the common law, you're trespassing.
No, we're not breaking any law. If you remove me, you assault me. Don't assault me. If you touch me, you assault me.
You're wrong.
If you touch me, you assault me. We're not breaking any law, we're in a public place. You haven't got the photo to report the right, it's a public place.
Stop by, yeah? I'm here as a journalist, so that's why I'm recording. I'm independent, I'm just monitoring what's going on, recording the evidence.
What's up to you guys? Either leave or you're being reported real
estate. For what reason? Where's your contract?
I'm here as a journalist.
Where's your contract? I'm going to ask this police officer again. Can you get his number? I've asked this police officer to show me his warrant card, which is legal obligation to show me his warrant card. Otherwise, you can be accused of impersonating a police officer. I've asked you to show me your warrant card, which is a legal request you've got to comply with.
Yes, you have. I've asked you for your warrant card.
You're breaking the law without if you're not carrying your warrant card. Have you got your warrant card?
So I really don't know where to point my camera here. However, so we've got two different situations happening here, two incidents. We've got three incidents now. So it looks like we've got three situations here. Going back for the third interaction. It looks like there might be an arrest here. So we got one arrest here. think the other two people have just been escorted off. I'm not carrying my gimbal at the moment. That's why the shaky footage. Okay, they've been taken out into the back there. At the beginning, the police were advising people to leave. I do believe that the security should have been advising people to leave, not the police. The police seem to have been acting a little bit with a lack of impartiality, should I say. So the SIA Meadow Hall security did intervene and the police assisted. Now in my opinion, from my view, there was enough security here to deal with that unless an arrest had to be taken place. So one was arrested. I'm not sure what he was arrested for. There's more security coming back now. So I'm going to guess they're going to ask people to leave in a minute. And then they'll escort people off in the same way. So I'm staying back now to see if they target the camera. So I've advised the security I'll be leaving with the last people just to make sure everybody's safe and well. The security have to be seen to be doing the job correctly, and this is the reason why I'm documenting this.
Sorry guys.
Yeah, I've just informed. Do you want to just I just advised. I'm collecting all the evidence, and I'll leave him with the last person.
I'm leaving now, sir.
Yeah. They've gone. So do you want to just talk to your colleague and advise the same?
If you're leaving, mate, we're...
Yeah. They believe in it so much, they shouldn't be anywhere near us.
This way, sir.
Right, okay. So you're going to take it upon yourself to escort me out?
You've been asked to leave now, so you're technically trespassing on private property.
Fair enough.
So as long as you keep leaving, sir, I don't have to put my hands on you to remove you.
I understand that law.
Keep walking in that direction. And I don't, as long as he keeps walking.
I understand that law. I'm walking backwards, be careful. Just make sure I don't fall, won't you?
I'll make sure you don't fall over, sir. I've got a duty of care to you, whether or not you're causing a problem. Plant pot there, young man.
Which way?
That way.
Yeah, okay.
Trying to keep you from falling over.
No worries, yeah.
That's all.
Alright, at the end of the day, the security has to be seen to be doing the job correctly, and this is why I'm documenting it.
Yeah,
I'm not going to judge you right now. Obviously, the video is all recorded.
Yeah, I've got no problem with you for recording it at all. As I've said, though.
Are you security as well?
Now that we've asked you to leave, you are on private property. Yeah, you're trespassing. Yeah. All right.
That's why I'm leaving, because you've advised me to leave. And you've trespassed me.
Why was everybody asked to leave?
Did you get your FA badge on you, by the way?
The manager's walking away. He's walking away from a poignant question. Why was everybody else asked to leave?
Right, you refuse to show your SA badge, are you? Yeah, if you haven't got an SA badge, mate, you're working illegally in security.
Have you got your SIA badge on show?
Don't talk to me about the law. If you haven't got an SA badge, you're acting illegally, you're working illegally. We're not trespassing at all. We're not trespassing at all. No, we're not. No, we're not.
Yeah, off the pot. If I get round to my car, that's right round in front of
Right, I need to see your SIA badges. They're not on display. That's a breach of SIA conditions.
You've got to display
you need to display your badge at all times while you're working with the public. Where is your badge? Does the SIA have it? Is it invalid? Why do you not have an SIA badge showing? And why does your colleague not have an SIA badge showing?
None of them have.
I will take this up with the SIA then. I'm asking you again, one more time. Where is your SIA badge?
That one's called Pie Man.
I'm going to advise you to go and get your SIA badge and put it on display.
You'll be sued for assault.
So you know, I've got an SIA badge.
Well, show it then. You've got to display it.
I've already asked you to leave.
It should be on display at all times.
Anyone working in security has to display their SIA badge.
No comment.
See, you don't know what you're talking about, mate. You've got no idea. You haven't got an SIA badge. If you have, right, show it. Because by law, you've got to display it when you're working in security.
Keep talking, pal.
Right, I don't need to keep talking about it because I've got you banged to rights, mate. You're working in security illegally without an SIA badge. You're working illegally without an SIA badge.
Have you worn your SIA badge at all today?
No,
have you worn it today? Have you worn it at all today?
You've got no SIA badge. You're
yeah, why is it in your pocket?
I don't need to have it on display.
Are you working overtly or covertly? If you're working covertly, you can hide it.
By the way, he's assaulted two people without an SIA badge, which means he's broken the law, which means he's guilty of assault.
Thank you.
Oh, yeah, off your pot.
Bye.
Go and search for it. Go and search for SIA application that was probably turned down, you muppet.
He is such a prick.
You've just been arrested and de-arrested, is my understanding.
Yeah.
So, I'm just in the shade. Just let me have a look at that. So, there's broken skin there.
Yeah.
And what did they give as an excuse to arrest you?
They said, oh, I've been injured as well.
Oh, your arms are injured, yeah?
Yeah.
Oh,
arms.
My God.
So let me just double check that. Anywhere else?
That's disgusting.
That's fresh, sort of bleeding.
So, anywhere else?
It was bleeding your forehead.
Might as well.
And the ankles?
God.
And this on your head as well, it looks like it's dried up in the heat. Can I just have a look at your head? Keep still.
I think it was an old scab ripped off.
Oh, is it an old scab? Right, okay. So, have they de-arrested you?
Yeah.
What did they say to you when they de-arrested you?
So they de-arrested me, said he took my phone number, they're going to look at the evidence, they've seized my camera as well.
Wow!
They've stolen your property then?
So they've stolen your property?
They're going to look at it for evidence, they're going to look at a CCTV, etc. And then they're going to ring me up and decide what they're going to do.
Why was you asked to leave?
I can't remember because I was actually asking to see their risk assessment. Which I had to conclude that they don't have a risk assessment for the wearing of masks, breaching management health and safety work regulations 1999. regulation 3, and certainly 3B, they should not enforce any mask wearing without the appropriate risk assessment. And all they told me was that the risk assessments, we have loads of risk assessments, but they can't produce the specific one, which is in breach of the regulations. And nobody would answer it. They all shied away from it. So they're unlawfully in there trying to enforce a system that is in breach of the regulations.
Was you asked to leave at all?
I wasn't personally asked. He was asked, and he was escorted. He was assaulted, actually.
Was you asked to leave?
I was asked to leave, yeah, but no reasoning why.
So they didn't give you a reason why to leave?
No. Because I was a part of that. Nothing, no individual reason. And they escorted me out of the back, and they said they tried to force me to cross the bridge and make me walk the long way round. So I just sat on the bridge, and they actually waited there for 10 minutes to make sure I couldn't walk down here. But then they got bored, they left, so I walked back this way.
I believe that the constable that assaulted me and arrested me and escorted me away, I said to him, when did you arrest me? Because there was no, I don't recall you reading me my rights.
No caution.
And that he said it was a situation that it was unapplicable to do it at the time.
Bullshit, you've got caution.
When I was inside the police station here in Meadowhall, they still didn't read me my rights. And I said to him, because he said, they said, we need to take your picture. I said, why are you taking my picture? I haven't been arrested. He said, no, we've de-arrested you now, but we arrested you and then de-arrested you.
You can't take your picture.
They have done. I had no choice.
Well, I know.
There was two of them and I'm in fucking handcuffs. They wouldn't even take
it. It sounds like they're going to do an investigation at this point.
Yeah.
Did they ask you to leave?
No, they told me I was leaving.
Yeah, right, I see.
Well, they didn't give us a choice. You saw it on camera, didn't you? They grabbed him and they grabbed me from behind and started marching us out for no reason, which is assault.
You intervened with something, obviously, that was taking place.
Yeah.
And you, in your head, in your mind at that time, what did you believe?
I believed that he was going to be seriously assaulted because there was, I think, four or five people around him at the time. One was this sergeant that attacked me, arrested me, and then security as well. And I was just trying to stop him getting assaulted.
They never gave us a reason, they never gave us an excuse. As you know, I asked the police officer to show me his warrant card. They refused to show me it, so in my opinion, he was impersonating a police officer. The fact that he turned around and says, well, look at me, you can tell I'm police. Now, anyone can wear a fancy dress outfit saying the police, right? Anyone can wear that, you've done it yourself.
They were saying that Mark was coming across as aggressive. He wasn't, he was just talking. He has got a hearing problem, so therefore he speaks louder than a normal person. And, you know, all of us know that. He has also said it out loud as well, and that they completely ignored that as well. And as far as we're concerned, they were acting unlawfully, because at the end of the day, yes, this is a private privately owned shopping center premises and that, but as soon as they open the doors, that's implied rights of access, because they're opening to the public. Well, we're members of the public. We've also stipulated that we're exempt as well from wearing a face covering. But they're insisting that you can't be in there without a face covering. Well, that's unlawful.
So what did he actually say to you before he escorted you out?
He just said, you're leaving a building because you're trespassing.
Yeah.
And the reason they asked you to leave was because...
Well, it's in our opinion, they came up and saw us, we're the only people without masks on, and they turn around and says, in my opinion, they ejected us for no reason. The police officer was trying to say, you have to wear a face mask in this building. I said, no, you don't, it's not a law. There's no law saying anyone has to wear a face mask. The police actually said, you've been asked to leave because you're not wearing a face mask. Right? Simple as that.
They said I'm going to be banned from here, but I don't know why. When, as far as I was concerned, under the current government's legislation, word for word in that, we were acting within that legislation and they were acting out of it. So therefore, as far as I'm concerned, they were acting unlawfully.
It's disability discrimination. It's as simple as that. The fact of the matter is, we've been asked to leave for no reason. Several of us have been assaulted by security guards without SIA licences. As you saw, you recorded...
Or at least not on display.
By law, they've got to display their SIA licences. They've got an SIA badge, you know this yourself. I worked on the doors for 20 years, I know exactly that myself. They refused to show their SIA licences. You saw the arrogant little prick. And as soon as we started challenging them on the SIA licences, they toddled off, didn't they? Because they know they're breaking the law. Right? The fact of the matter is, those people without an SIA badge are just members of the public like me and you in a high-vis vest that have assaulted him, me, him and him. And we've been assaulted by security guards not wearing SIA badges, and the police have refused to show the warrant cards when asked to show them. So they've broken the law, simple as that.
Well, just to put my interjection here, I do believe they may have SIA licences, but they obviously haven't got them on show.
which is one of the regulations they've breached. It must be shown at all times.
Yeah.
Obviously, that's something for the SIA to follow up.
If you didn't see their SIA badge, what makes you think they've got their SIA badge then?
Well, this is it. You know,
without showing it, you can't say that, can you?
Controversially as it is, it needs to be on show.
Yeah, it does.
That's part of the regulations.
Where you work in security, you've got to display your SIA badge. Right, you have to. You have to wear it on a little collar. When I worked on the doors, mate, you have to wear it on the collar of your coat or a jacket or whatever.
Right.
A little band, a little orange band, saying your security, your official security guards. And they were not displaying SIA licences. They refused to show their SIA licences. So we've been assaulted by security guards without SIA licences, in my opinion. And we've been asked to leave for discrimination reasons because we don't wear masks. We're exempt from wearing masks. And the police illegally told us that we have to show exemption. As I said in the government website, clearly says nobody has to prove exemption. And that's it.